Welcome all of you once again. I can see some 10 attendees who are there right now. So let me start with my introduction. My name is Sandeep Ranjan. I take care of corporate relations and career services at Soil Institute of Management. I have 18 years of experience both in corporate and campus placements. In corporate, I have mostly worked with recruitment consulting firms, and in campus placements, I have worked with B schools like Indian School of Business and Great Lakes Institute of Management, which were just before joining Soil. To start with, let me just talk about what we do exactly at Soil as far as Corporate Connect and career services are concerned, and then I'll give you a bit of snapshot on the placements for the current academic year, and then we can go ahead with the Q&A session. Starting with the Corporate Connect at Soil, it's a very unique way where we introduce students to the Corporate Connect. While there are certain activities which is common with other B schools also, but there are certain things which is unique to Soil. When the student comes into the campus and start the academic year, our first connect starts immediately, where we introduce the students to the corporate external mentors. So each and every student is assigned to an external mentor. These mentors are responsible for mentoring the students throughout the year. The students can meet these external mentors. As per their convenience of the student and the mentor, these mentors are senior leaders from the corporate who are ready to give time for mentoring the students. Interact throughout the year to extract benefit out of these corporate mentors. Then the second corporate connect for the students start post 2-3 months into the academic year. When the students, there is a time for projects with the corporate. So students either go for life project or internship with the corporate, which is a longer duration connect with the corporate. The students get project in the area of interest, marketing, finance, analytics, HR. And there is a corporate mentor from the company side, and then there is a faculty mentor from the campus side. And the students interact with the corporate mentor from the company to understand what is the project all about, to give a brief of the project, what they have done, to understand whether the project is in line with the motive of the objective of the project. And finally, they submit the report, the project report to the corporate. Then throughout the year, we also organize various corporate leaders and leaders from various walks of life visiting to our campus. So we run a leadership series where we have senior leaders who are visiting from the various walks of life, be it corporate, be it artist, be it a sportsman, be it a social worker. And then we have a guest lecture series where we have corporate leaders from various companies, industries, functions, businesses coming and taking the students through their journey, and so that the students can learn from their journey. The last and I think that's the most important thing which happens with the student at Soil campus is the placements, which we start at the end of October, early November. When the students get ready for their placements, the companies start visiting the campus, start considering the students for the various roles and requirements which they have. And we have companies coming from all industry sectors, consulting, IT, e-commerce, manufacturing, automobile, marketing, retail. They come, banking, BFSI sector, they come and hire our students, for various positions. So that's the kind of corporate journey a student goes through right from the start of the academic year to the end of the academic year. And students get ample opportunity to interact with the corporate. And by the time they are ready to join the corporate, they go through a lot of transformation through these interventions, which are arranged by the corporate and career services team. To give you a brief of the placements, which I think would be one of the most important thing which all the attendees would be keen to know. For the current academic year, we have already placed approximately 76% of the students, we have two programs, postgraduate program in business leadership, postgraduate program in HR leadership. So the current average of the postgraduate program in business leadership is 10.8 lakhs per annum, and with the highest salary being 18 lakhs per annum. And for the HR leadership program, the average stands at 9.42 lakhs per annum, with highest being 12.37 lakhs per annum. So this is quite high. You know, there has been a substantial increase in the average salary when compared to the last year. And we had companies like HCL, Infosys, Accenture, Wipro, Tech Mahindra, Genpact, Cognizant, Mahindra and Mahindra. You know, these are the kind of companies, to name a few, who have visited and hired students from our campus. The business leadership program, students have been hired for roles like business analyst, project management, product management, sales leadership program, pre-sales, consultant, senior consultant. Those are the kind of roles which has been offered to the business leadership program. As far as the HR leadership program is concerned, the roles which have been offered to the HR students ranges from you know, talent acquisition, HR generalist, HR BP, people connect. Then, you know, these are the kind of roles which normally a HR student has been offered by companies who have come from various industry sector, as I mentioned earlier, starting from consulting, IT, manufacturing, auto, retail, BFSI, etc. So that's the snapshot of the placements as of now. We hope to complete the entire placements by the convocation, which normally happens at SOIL. The convocation is due for 11th April this year. And in case, if we still have, you know, few students, three or four students still looking, waiting for their placements, we continue to support them till the time they place. So the endeavor behind placements is to ensure that all the students get ample opportunities, decent number of opportunities from decent companies, so that they have a fair, you know, attempt at getting the, you know, job of their choice and as per their capability and as per their area of interest. So now I'm ready to start the Q&A session. And as I speak, I have a question from Shivani Bhatnagar. So she asks, do we have active opportunities in the field of HR analytics and what is the package offered? So Shivani, HR analytics is the new trend in HR right now. HR has evolved a lot these days. You know, gone are the days of when an HR professional is expected to deliver on the conventional HR role. Today, the HR professionals are expected to be expert in or knowing digital in the area of HR, analytics in the area of HR. And we are no different. Our HR curriculum has huge content or huge focus on digital and HR analytics. And we have companies who come and hire the students for HR analytics role. One of the names which come right now in my mind is Genpact. Genpact this year has hired students who have a fair understanding of HR analytics. It's the HR BP role with a strong flavor of HR analytics. And the package offered by Genpact to the HR students is the highest package, that is 12.37 lakhs per annum. So I hope I am able to answer your question. I'll take the second question, which is from Rishabh Prakash. Sir, if someone has less than 60% in graduation, then how difficult is it is to get placed in SOIL, and what salary do they get placed? So Rishabh, you know, the, obviously somebody having less than 60%, the challenge is not about what kind of salary they can get. The challenge is mostly with the large, you know, companies who have a structured placement process. So some of the top IT firms like Infosys, HCL, Tech Mahindra, Accenture, they have a filtering of 60% throughout, and some of the companies even have 70% throughout. So somebody with less than 60% in either 10th, 12th of graduation, the challenge which he or she is going to face is that he will get filtered out. He may not be eligible for such kind of companies who will be offering various roles. So that is a challenge such kind of student is going to face. So it is mainly the number of opportunities they would be eligible for. Having said that, there are other companies who also look at students with, they don't mind looking at students with less than 60%. They don't have such criteria. So you will have, you can have an opportunity with such kind of companies. However, the salaries are completely defined by the policies of the company. So if the companies do not differentiate between students who are having 60% throughout or not having 60% throughout. So that I hope that answers your query, Rishabh. I'll go to the third question from Pranay Kumar, who says, I have 1+ years of experience in recruitment in a consulting firm, but I want to change my role. Is it possible? Pranay, I assume that you are interested in the HR leadership program. If yes, yes, there has been a possibility to change the role for students who have come from a recruitment consulting background. As I said, the HR companies who come to hire HR students, the roles which they offer are ranging from HR BP, HR generalist, HR manager, a management trainee HR, and these are corporate roles. So we have seen in the past a lot of students coming from the recruitment consulting background and moving to a corporate HR role. I move to the next question. We have Abhilasha who says, what kind of roles are provided if we do specialization in marketing and what is the salary range for the same? Abhilasha, marketing students typically gets a role ranging from business analyst, product manager, sales, business development, co-marketing, digital marketing, pre-sales. These are the kind of roles that normally a marketing student get. And we have seen traditionally the higher salaries normally goes to a marketing student only. So the salary range, if I say that the average salary this year has been 10.8 for a business leadership program, so that applies for marketing as well. The minimum salary benchmark at our campus is 7.5. So we don't have any companies coming and hiring below 7.5. And the maximum this year has been 18 lakhs per annum with an average of 10.8. So I hope that answers your question. I'll go to Saurabh Huria. He has a question which says, through soil, what kind of roles do we get in marketing? Saurabh, I have just answered your a question, earlier question where I have taken care of this query. So I hope you, if you have listened to that answer, that takes care of your question. I'll just take, I see some of the questions coming from the other section also, so I'll go through that. I have a question from Ankita Das Poddar. I would like to know how many pharma companies have participated in the placement drive so far and what are the roles being offered? So Ankita, while as far as the names are concerned, traditionally we have seen companies like Dr. Reddy's, Cipla, Narayana, Healthcare, Manipal Health, these are the kind of Max Healthcare, these are the kind of companies who have come and hired from campus in the healthcare and wellness domain. The roles, range from project management, marketing, sales, operations. Those are the kind of roles students get. But this is completely driven by how many students we have in a particular batch who have a background from pharma. So since the students come with prior work experience, the expectation from the company has that some students have some kind of pharma background. Either they have the basic qualification as B Pharma, M Pharma, or they have a experience in the healthcare or the pharmaceutical sector. So this year we had a couple of students, and the companies who have considered them, these students are companies like Dr. Reddy's, Manipal, Narayana Healthcare, and Max Healthcare. These are the kind of companies who have visited this year as well. Vaibhav Singh, could you please tell me the total number of students in HR quarter and how many are placed? Vaibhav, we had 23 students in HR cohort for the batch of 2019-20. And till now, we have 18 students who have been placed and 5 students are yet to be placed. But, and we have a few companies in pipeline who are considering these 5 students. So we don't see a challenge in placing all these students 100%. Ishan Sharma says eligibility for both PGs, 10th, 77, 12th, 69, graduation 59. Work ex in a bank for 1.5 year. Be working as a mutual research 3+ year. Am I eligible? As I said, Ishan, earlier, you are eligible for all the companies who don't have a criteria of 60% or 70% throughout. As I said, there are some companies, mostly the large IT firms, that look at the minimum 60% throughout. And the moment I share the profile with them, they filter out the students who have less than 60%. So those are the companies you will not be eligible to apply for, but otherwise you are eligible to apply for any other company who don't have such criteria. Tulika Mishra says, what is the ratio of on-campus and off-campus placement in soil? What are basically the rounds during the placements? Tulika, off-campus placement, if I understand rightly, you're talking about students pursuing the placements on their own. There are very few students, who pursue the placements on their own. This happens mostly post, convocation. If there are students left, 3 or 4 students left, then they start also looking out for a job on their own. But mostly it's 99% is supported by the campus. Typically, the rounds of placements during a campus placement is, companies conduct depending on what their need is. They can conduct a group discussion or an aptitude test or a psychometric test, and then they have one round of technical interview and one round of HR interview. This is the normal process, while the exact process differs from company to company. Yashika Tangri asks, does the field of graduation affect placements? As in, are students from commerce or engineering background likely to be favored during the placements? In some cases, Yashika, yes. IT companies, they prefer hiring students with a BTech or engineering background. Finance companies prefer to hire, or companies offering finance role, they prefer to hire with students with commerce or chartered accountancy background. Having said that, the students from other streams like BBA, BSc, BA also have enough number of roles where they are eligible to apply. Nishita Jha asks, sir, does previous company's CTC matters in placement? No, Nishita. The moment students get placed through campus, the companies don't look at the previous salary. It's strictly basis on what kind of salary range they offer on the campus, and they, depending on how the student fits, they decide on the exact salary which is necessarily in the salary range which they have stated to us. We have seen, the students' CTC increasing by 110-120% when you compare the pre-MBA and the post-MBA salaries. And normally in the market, you don't get such high increments. So if the salary offered at the campus was based on the prior past salary, then this would not have been possible. So, to answer your question, this doesn't, your past salary doesn't matter for the companies who come to the placement process. Ankita Das Poddar, do IT companies consider students from non-technical background, non-engineering for analytics role? Ankita, as answered earlier, IT companies do have a preference for the BTech or engineering background students. So that is something you'll find in 90% of the cases. Some of the companies are okay to look at students with non-technical background also, but then in that case, they look at the domain knowledge of the student. So if an IT company is operating in the banking and financial sector domain, they expect students to have a knowledge of that domain. Ankita Das Poddar, what is the average salary range for the analytics student? Ankita, I don't have the exact salary range right now, but it is close to what I have stated for the entire business leadership program. It's around 10.8. So the analytics average salary would be closer to that. Anish Trakru, hi sir, does the international exchange program help in placements? Oh, Anish, to be very frank, it doesn't as much, because the international exchange program happens almost one or two months before the program ends. So we start placements in October, and the international exchange program happens somewhere in end of February, early March. So by the time most of the 75-80% of the batch is placed, so that doesn't make that much of a difference. Vaibhav Singh has asked, did any company offer plant HR role? Yes, there have been companies who have offered plant HR role. Companies like Anand Group, then Mahindra & Mahindra, these are the companies who offer plant HR role. And I believe the best experience for any HR student to start his career is from plant HR. Ishan Sharma, is there 100% in HR? Ishan, yes. We normally have almost 100% placements every year. As I stated earlier, current batch, 23 students, 18 students have been placed, only 5 left. And we have enough companies in pipeline to place these 5 students. There is an anonymous person who is asking, is graduation stream and past experience taken into consideration while recruiting students? Yes, it is considered. This is a one-year MBA program where students come with prior work experience, and the companies who come to hire here, they look for students with experience. So depending on what is your graduation stream and depending on how many years of past experience, which sector, which industry, which domain, the role, the salaries differ as per that. Then we have Monet. Good evening, sir. What are the roles offered for analytics stream? Monet, the role for analytics stream ranges from business analytics, business analyst, data scientist, consulting. Those are the kind of roles offered mostly by core analytics firms like Mu Sigma, Factor Analytics, LatentView, even the IT, large IT firms like HCL, Infosys, Tech Mahindra, Accenture, Cognizant. These are the companies who look to hire students from the analytics team. I'll go to another set of questions. We have question from Shivani Bhatnagar once again. Sir, can we sit for selective companies during placements? Yes, Shivani. The process is that when we get a requirement for the company, it is open for inviting applications from all the students. The students are allowed to decide on their own which companies they want to apply. But once applied for the companies, they have to go through the process. They can't withdraw in between. And if the company gives an offer which is as per the salary range given in the JD while sharing the JD, the student has to accept the offer and move out of the placement process. Abu Manson says, what's your institute ranking? Abu, we have been recently ranked by Business World and MBA Universe. We have been ranked at one of the top 13 and top 18 MBA programs in India. So that's a recent ranking which we have for Soil right now. We have Himang Kapoor asking, what kind of companies from consulting background come this time? So we have companies like Accenture, Cognizant, then we have we had companies like Cartesian Consulting, then we had companies like Circular Angle. These were the kind of companies who have come and hired from the consulting background. Roles they provide is mostly into the as a associate analyst or a consultant or a senior consultant role, and in the area of consulting naturally. So if there are companies who are in management consulting, there are companies in the IT consulting, there are companies in the HR consulting. So depending on which domain they operate, they offer roles in that domain. Pranay Kumar asked, could I know how many students in HR are yet to be placed? I have already answered. Out of 23, 5 are available for placements as of now. Himank again asks, what is the packages consulting company offers? All these consulting companies have offered packages ranging from anywhere between 7.5 to 8 lakhs to somewhere around 14-15 lakhs per annum. So that has been the range from the consulting company this year. Rishabh Prakash asks, how do we get the company for a live project? Rishabh, as I stated earlier during my introduction, the live project is one of the areas where you know, the corporate and career services team helps students in getting connected with the companies. So while the corporate and career services team are responsible for getting live projects for you, the students are also you know, allowed to search a live project for themselves. But before they confirm the live project, they have to get it you know, rectified or verified with the faculty and the career services team before they can proceed ahead with the live project, which is procured on their own. Pranay Kumar asked, what is the minimum salary for HR? Pranay, this year the HR, we had few students with 0 years of experience who have gone for an empty fresher level role. So the minimum salary this year has been 6.5 lakhs per annum. Sajjan has asked, what role did English Helper and Solveda offer last year? What is the salary bracket for them? Sajjan, you know, Solveda, I don't remember right now. It's not handy with me. But English Helper, as I remember correctly, the role was mostly from analytics, and the salary offered was between 7 to 10 lakhs per annum. We have Saurabh Khuria asking, has any advertising agency hired someone from a soil in the past? Saurabh, I have not seen in any of the MBA colleges advertising agency and coming and hiring from an MBA college. And this is as per my experience from my ISP as well as Great Lakes days, and the same is applicable in soil as well. The reason I'll tell you is because A, they prefer going to a mass communication college where they get the right kind of people which they normally want to hire, and B, even if they want to hire an MBA student, the salaries are not as high as per the soil standards, and so, you know, the salaries are lower than even the minimum salary which minimum campus hygiene which soil has. So these are the two reasons primarily you don't see advertising agency coming and hiring from an MBA college like soil. Oh, Abhilasha Gautam wants to know, I would like to know the number of students in BLP program and how many of them are placed. Abhilasha, as on date, we had 61 students from the business leadership program. And till date, we have around 46 students who have been placed. So we have around 15 students still available for placements as of now. We have Pranay Kumar asking, sir, in HR, does IT companies look for past IT experience? Pranay, this answer to this question would not be straightforward. I'll tell you why, because most of the students who come and join the HR leadership program, they come with an experience which is not relevant for HR. So they don't come with an HR experience, be it an HR generalist or a HR manager or a talent acquisition or a HR consulting role. So when an HR student actually goes for a HR role in an IT company, obviously the companies get excited with the students who have worked in IT companies, because they understand the culture of an IT company, how an IT company operates, and you know, while working in IT companies, they have also handled some of the people related issues. So that gives an advantage for the students who have an IT background and they are seeking an HR role in the IT companies. Ideally, HR companies would prefer to look at the relevant HR functional experience, but we normally don't have more than 2-3 students having a prior HR experience. So this is where the relevance with your prior experience does matter for an IT company. Abhilasha Gautam, if we are placed in a company, then do we move out of the placement process? Abhilasha, yes, we have a one-offer policy. If a company comes with a JD sharing a salary range, which is as per the soil salary benchmark, if you apply for that, you have to participate in the process. If you get an offer where the seasonal after the JD, you have to take that offer and move out of the placement process. You don't get a second opportunity. I'll go to the another set of questions. Nishita Jha, she's asking, is there any opportunity for international placement? Yes, we have one or two companies who have come and hired for international placements in the past. That's mostly in the Gulf countries. So that's the kind of roles which international roles have been offered at the campus. Anonymous attendee says, I'm from an aviation sector and opted for marketing. Is there any company which can consider aviation as work experience? In the history of Soil or in the past recruiters of Soil, there has hardly been any company from the aviation sector, but there are some of the IT companies who work in the aviation domain. So companies, IT companies who are looking at students with pre-sales or a business analyst or a sales kind of role, where the students are supposed to, where the company is providing IT services to the aviation sector, there your experience can be of value and relevance. The question is from again an anonymous attendee saying, what would the market downgrade affect the placement 2021? My guess is as good as yours. We really don't know how the market downgrade is going to affect the placements. While we have seen some of the companies this year, their numbers have gone down, but the positive thing is our average salaries have gone up by more than a lakh. So we really don't know how to judge on this. And we really don't know, placement 2021 is more than almost a year away. So what kind of effect it is going to have? If the market goes up, we might see a surge in the placements. So this is something very difficult to answer at this point of time. Shantanu, Ambre, can we sit for more than one company for placement? Shantanu, you are allowed to sit for more than one company for placement till the time you get an offer. As I stated earlier, if the offer is given as per the JD and the salary range where you had applied, you have to take that offer and move out of the placement process. Monit asked me, as I come on sabbatical, can I sit for companies which offer 10 plus packages? Monit, all the sabbatical students are allowed to sit for a campus placement process in the campus till the time they opt out and they decide to go back to the sabbatical company. And as far as the 10 plus packages offered, it will depend on what prior work experience, what kind of experience do you carry. The salaries depend on that and how do you perform during the interviews. Having said that, you have a choice of applying for whatever company you want to apply for. Prashantini asks, sir, is there a scope for placement for candidates opting for HR with 10 plus years of IT technical experience? Prashantini, and I'll just complete the question. Does experience hold any value while opting HR? And also, will candidates with IT background considered for plant HR roles? Prashantini, I'll be very frank about it. With 10 years of experience, which is not relevant for HR, there will be challenges to get a value or get leverage on the past experience of 10 plus years. While some of the IT companies may be interested and they might give you a leverage on the past experience, which is from the IT sector, plant HR would be very difficult for them to give a leverage to your prior experience. Having said that, we had a few students in the past who have come with higher years of experience, even in the current batch. For instance, one of the students who has placed in Genpact came with almost 7 to 8 years of experience from a school teaching background, and she has been placed at Genpact with the highest salary. So some of the companies are open to look at students from any background, but there will be some companies find relevance with their IT companies might find the relevance with their prior work experience. Plant HR roles, extremely difficult to find relevance, but they may be open to value your experience in a corporate sector. So it again depends on company to company. The anonymous attendee has been asking this question again and again, would the market downgrade affect the placement 2021? I have already said yes. I've already said the answer to this question. Anish Takru, sir, do we have candidates in L&D department? Yes, HR students have been placed in L&D department. Then we have Pooja. Hello, sir, do we get the chance to go for other company if it provides better package in case I already have an offer in hand. Pooja, as I stated earlier, we have a one placement offer policy. So you are not allowed to sit for another company if you have one offer in hand. But, normally what we do, we try to get the companies with a better offer and better brand and better package in the start of the placement process so that the student get a fair chance on getting a better job with better package earlier in the placement process. So normally it doesn't happen that we have, except for a few cases where we have companies with better brand and better package coming in later in the placement process. What are the placement rounds conducted by companies or placement process in general for HR for students? I have already stated the placement process is common for both the programs. It can start with a GD, aptitude test, psychometric test, then a technical round, and then the HR round. The rounds may be different depending on company to company, but this is generally the norm which we have seen. We again have, can I know the company name which offered package of 18 lakhs for BLP program? Yes. It was Square Yards. Does my year of experience play important role in getting higher package? Pooja Singh. Yes, it does. As I stated earlier, companies come here to hire students with prior work experience. So student with higher experience have a chance to get a higher package, but that also depends how the company finds that experience relevant to the requirement. Our anonymous attendee again asked, what is the ideal amount of experience to have? See, if you're looking for a one-year program, the sweet spot is between 2 to 5 years of experience. That's where the maximum number of roles come from, maximum number of companies. So if you are between 2 to 5 years of experience, you will get the maximum chances to get a job. Ankita Daspadar, I am from life science background and working with an IT company, life science domain. If you want to do analytics specialization, what kind of roles can I expect to get and what would be the salary range? I have 3.5 years of experience. Ankita, if you opt for analytics specialization, you may get a data scientist or a business analyst or a pure data analytics role in a company with a life sciences background. That's where your experience would be relevant. However, the companies who come and hire for acquisition, they look mostly, people with the skill sets which is required for such kind of roles. So people who are good at SQL, R, Python, Tableau, data visualization, statistical methods. If they are good in that, the students can be considered irrespective of their past background. Coming to your what kind of salary you can expect, while I cannot tell that what kind of salary you can get with 3.5 years of experience, because that completely depends how the interview goes and how the company finds your relevance with the role. But typically our the current batch which is passing out, their average experience is around between 3.5 to 4 years for the entire batch, and the average salary is around 10.8 right now. So you can assume what kind of salaries you can get. What is the maximum experience for which a candidate may be considered for the HR program? We don't have any upper cap in terms of experience. As I said earlier, we have had students in the past with experience ranging from more than 7 years, and we even had students with 10, 11 years of experience. So we don't have an upper cap, but there are very few students at such a higher experience range. So there are more questions, but I may take some of them right now, and then rest of them I can get back to those questions. There is one more question. What are the salary structure if soil absorb their own candidates, roles they are getting? This is a question for Himang Kapoor. Extremely difficult to tell you right now, depending on what salaries, what roles, what department get they absorbed within soil, and the salary structure is defined by the company policy. So that completely depends on the role. Sir, how many companies visited for HR profiles? This year we had around 20, 22 companies we have visited till now. Sir, do soil as a student placement committee? Yes, the student placement committee is there, which is selected by the corporate and career services team through a democratic process, and these students help in carrying out the roles which corporate and career services play. Which company offered highest package in BLP this year, and what is the role? I have already stated that. So I think that those are the questions we had right now. I have answered the query, all the queries which has come to me right now during this webinar. So I'll take a leave right now, guys. All the best. If you have any further question, you can always get in touch with the admissions team. Any questions which are related to placements or Corporate Connect, the placement team is going to direct it to me, and I'll surely try to give answers to all the questions. Wishing you all the best, and thanks a lot once again.